Hello from the Hilltop. Welcome to today's Alumni Career Services webinar sponsored by the Georgetown University Alumni Association. I'm Jihei Kim, Assistant Director of Alumni Career Services. Thank you all for joining us for today's webinar, The Art of Networking, presented by Coach Leo Borello, our GUAA Career Coaching Partner. Before we get started, I'd like to share a few webinar tips and reminders. This webinar is being recorded and it will be made available to all registrants on our Alumni Career Services YouTube channel within 48 hours of today's broadcast. You will receive the link to the webinar recording in a webinar follow-up email, which will also contain a post-webinar survey for you to take, information on upcoming webinars, and more ways to stay connected with Georgetown Alumni Career Services. Coach Leo will take questions at the end of his presentation, so please feel free to send in questions throughout the webinar using the Questions for the GUACS Webinar Presenter button on your screen. Finally, if you're having any technical difficulties, please submit those through the Questions button as well. Without further ado, I'm pleased to introduce our webinar presenter, Coach Leo. Coach Leo Borello is a bilingual performance leadership coach for both English and Spanish speaking professionals. With 30 years of coaching experience, Leo is certified by Georgetown University and the International Coach Federation. Originally from Argentina, he has lived in New York City where his business is based since 2012. Leo uses his unique skills and experiences to advance and empower Latino leaders to maximize their professional growth in today's changing workforce. Coach Leo, we're eager to hear from you today, so I'll turn things over to you.
Everyone, I really appreciate your presentation. Jay, thank you very much. Thank you to Georgetown. Thank you to you all for being here today for our webinar. I really appreciate your time. So my name is Leandro Borello. People call me Leo or Coach Leo. So jumping to our topic today, we are going to talk about networking and networks and the art of networking. So networking is a long-term relationship, something that we build along our time, or along our wake, where we are coming, waking along our life. So it evolves, meeting and getting to know people who can assist us, who can potentially help us to build our life and to build our reputation and build our profession. But at the same time, we need to help them. Mostly, we need to help them, so in return, they're gonna help us. Your network includes everyone from your friend, family, work colleagues, business connection, social network, member of group to which you belong, everyone. So how do we connect with those of people? We connect with those of people that are in our network, building relationships, sharing information, bring us opportunity. It pull resources and expand our contacts. Networking is about connecting with people, not collecting people. So long-term relationship and good reputation, meeting and getting to know people, is those people can be our friend, family, colleague, business connection, people that we know or people that we want to know. It's a totally fact that a group can perform much better than a person who is striving alone. When it comes to making decisions, your network can exercise a very healthy influence and improve your decisions. So connecting with people, not collecting people. Like a skill, life, building a life skill in while we are living in our life, what is important is to know what those people are related with us, what kind of people are them? Because, as I said, a person is known by the company they keep. So those people that we are surrounded for they determine us along the way. I am because of what other people have made of me. For example, when we are social people, when we were born, without our parents or someone who take care of us, we couldn't exist. So in the same mode, right now in our life, we need the people around now to going improving our life, improving our profession. For example, right now when we send a resume to a company, we got thousands of resumes on the desk. So people usually get job when they connect through people. So being a social product, we are affected and influenced by others, especially those who are related to us, and vice versa. Therefore, you become like your network. If you have a wonderful network, you will become a wonderful person. Your network can be increased or decreased due to a caliber of people in your circle. You will be the same person in 5 years as you are today, except for two things: the people you meet and the books you read. So we are not the same along the time. Networking is an asset that adds value in our life and create a return and invest in the future, in our life, and in the life of others. Our power is multiplied when we work together. It's a fuel that accelerates our success. It, on one hand, it's an investment in our future, but also it's an asset in the present moment. It creates fruit connection and generate new opportunities for your career. Whether you are a corporate employee, self-employee, professional, or entrepreneur, networking is sure to help you climb the ladder to success. It's a huge sign of being a leader. It shows that you are capable of leading the people in your field. Your networking determines your total worth. Your total worth, not only in terms of money or status, job, etc., but in terms of how rich you are when it comes to your overall worth. If you are in trouble of any kind, you are looking and seeking for resources. Where are you going to look for them? So how many resources are at your hand? It depends of your network. The source you have, how resourceful are you? Where are you gonna find the answer to your question when you don't know them? In your network, a network can be seen as a system of interconnected people, as we saw in the picture, while a net worth can be linked to the sum total of a person's wealth. So network on one side and network on the other side. So if we get together with people whose quality is high, we become who they are. We see the people that are involved in good job, we are gonna find good jobs. There are different contrasting views respect the a concept of networking. For some people, For some people, networking can leave a bad taste in their mouths, like very annoying, very unpleasant. Sorry, Google Home, shut up. Other people find something fun when they are going to network, but for other people it's something very difficult. So how is for us? For us, sometimes we go to network in an environment that we don't like. For example, we go to network to we like soccer, we like American football. If we can network there, but maybe those are not the space where we are going to find the people that are going to connect us with the job we are looking for. So networking is taxing. It's taxing. It's heavy topic because we are we are not comfortable. We need to jump for our comfortable zone. So we need to make a plan in order to take advantage of this situation that is a must for us. In the book, Never Eat Alone, Kate Ferrazzi say that a fatal mistake people make is failing to realize that building a strong network is just like any other goal. No, it's important goal. You need an action plan who you want to build connections with. So we can make two lists. In one list, where we can put all the people that we want to strengthen our relationship. In that list, we already know those people, family, friends, colleagues, people have met in the university, people have met at work. On the other list, on the other side, another list, a second list, will be people that you want to meet. For example, leaders at work, members of your community, you want to be involved as an influencer in your niche. So that is creating a plan. So when you make that plan, you decide what action you're gonna do in along the months, a quarter, and a year. So having in mind, this is a strategy plan. Take a list and decide actions you are going to take to meet and strengthen your relationship. As you do this, strategize the best way to connect with each individual. For example, having a coffee or inviting people to have a lunch. So every week on Sunday, we can make plan how I will meet my first list and second list during this week and farther on. Social media is important. It's a tool where we need to rely on. It's a revolution, a tool for networking. Sites like LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram can be a extraordinary tool for expanding and deepening your connections with business contacts, clients, potential partners. However, it's important to have a well-informed approach. Many business owners make the mistake of using the traditional hard sell on social media and then wonder why their efforts do not pay off. For example, I receive an invitation on LinkedIn with a long text offering me to buy one service of that person. That is a hard sell. When we connect with people, take this example in LinkedIn, we need to offer something without expecting anything in return. We can offer, when someone connects with us on LinkedIn, we got an invitation, we can think who I can introduce this person with. So I give him something. Don't think about taking. I want to get a job, I want to get knowledge, I want to meet people that are important. No, we think we need to be less selfish and give things to others because we are plenty full of resources and the other people are too. So if we give them, they are going to give us. So start building our social presence, start posting interesting content, be ethical, we have a good manners when we start meeting people, even though in on the social media. Focus on quality instead of quantity. Ask a question, how many people are in my Facebook account that I am not in contact with? I don't know who they are. How many people are on my LinkedIn profile connected with? So how many business cards are on my desk? What did I do after the last meetup where I met people at brought business card? Did I connect with them? Did I follow up with them? So what did I do? Otherwise, I'm wasting time. I'm wasting my time, and I wasted other people's time. And I'm wasting something that is beautiful, that I enjoy in life. Because at one point, the first expectation we can have when we go to networking is to know a person and to build a relationship as a friend. An acquaintance first and a friend later. So if we have as an expectation, meet one, two persons in a meetup, and then we do a follow-up, with time, we are getting to know people and we start connecting and empathize, and we start getting alone and being friends. So focus on quality and not quantity. So make an action plan building relationships. Building relationships. It's not a matter to have list of people that we don't do anything with them. So now let's talk about the tips when we go to a networking. First, there is a moment that the first thing that we have to do in a networking event is filling out a name tag, something that no one likes. Here is an insider tip that I applied to me, and maybe it's good for you. Is before putting your name and the company name, look around what other people had put in their tag. Otherwise, we can make a mistake. There are numerous occasions where what happened? People had put the whole name plus the company name, and we only put our nickname, for example, or the opposite. Other people had put their nickname or name, and we put the whole name and the company name, almost our resume in our tag. So first, how to make our tag? It can feel ridiculous, but it's important because when you are gonna meet the person is gonna see your name and need to have something in your tag that can be used to break ice. For example, you can add what is called a starter conversation, like putting in your, in my case, being a coach, I can put Coach Leo and below a leadership, executive leadership guru. So it attracts attention. If you are in sales business, you can put non-spammy sales guy. So, or marketing magician. So something that attract other people to see you. Well, that is the first thing, the tag. Then where to stand in an event, where we are going to take a place. They are to take the more advantage we can. So here we are. Name tag, where to stand. The biggest mistake usually we make is planting ourselves right at the entrance of a networking event. And why? Because when we go to a networking event, usually it's after work and we want to go to the bathroom, want to grab a drink, I want to know where we go, because maybe we schedule a moment to go to the event, but we don't remember what kind of event we are going. So the big mistake is standing up in the entrance when people walk into the event. You have to give them time to breathe. Instinctively, we are in a new place around new people. We want two things: nourishment, typically drink or food, and survey the room. So don't plan yourself right in the door, in the doorway. Anyone we approach there is going to be looking around and not paying attention to what we are saying. So another place where we can stand up at this school is standing in line to get a drink or to get a food. Never pass the opportunity to meet someone who is behind us or standing in before us. It's an opportunity to start a conversation and to understand what those people are and what those people are doing in their life. So when we get to the plate, also another advice, another tip is don't fool the plate with food, because if a plastic plate could fall and all the food go to the floor and embarrassing yourself in front of other people. And also, if you are going to the event to networking, not to eat. So what is the goal for you is to have a lunch or a dinner, okay, that is your first idea, great. But if you are going to meet people, the first goal is to put all the other things aligned with the goal. So grab a few food, put in your plate, and go away to meet someone. The interesting thing is when you put less food in your plate, and the plate is empty, and you are talking with someone, and that person, you don't want to talk anymore because you feel like it's wasting time or it's not a good connection for you. So you can say, okay, I'm going to pick more food. That is a good excuse. And another working event also, the best position is at the bar. When people grab the drink, so stay like 3 feet from the bar, and while the person grabs the beer or the drink, whatever, is ready to start a conversation with someone. So is this someone, maybe me, maybe you. So that is interesting. And if you are getting nervous, what happened with everyone, for example, today is my first webinar in my life. So that's the reason why I'm nervous. And also because I never studied English until I moved to the United States 7 years ago. So my English is still need improve. So, but if you are in a network event, and you are nervous and your hands start sweating. So one technique is to put the glass in your right hand with a tissue, so the tissue can help you to dry your hand, and the moment you are going to meet the person, pass the drink to the left hand and shake the other person, so your hands are going to be dry. That's a good tip to have in mind. It's interesting that happened to some people. Another tip in the event is, where do you put your business card? I had a moment where people in the event, they say, I didn't bring business card. I don't have a business card. Or I start looking for the business card and they don't know where to find out. So my little advice is to have the left pocket for the other people business card and the right pocket for your business card. So you already know, don't need to stay around looking for the business card. You already know where to look for. And the problem also comes when you need to remember names, because especially, for example, for me, in America, the names are not similar to the country I used to live. So it's more difficult for me to remember names that are for America, North America, or Asian people, Indian people. So how do I do to remember those names? But another technique I found is plus the business card exchange your phone contact. If the person for you is important connection, exchange the phone contact just right away. So you tell the person, give me your phone contact, or I will give you my phone contact, so the other person give you her or his phone phone, and you tap your name and your phone, and then make a call so you have a lost call, and then ask the person to put their name. So you already have the person's name and with good spell. And another, some people, I feel it's too much, some people take a picture of the other person to remind them who this picture was, this person was, but I think that is too much. It's invading the privacy. But exchange the phone, and that is going to facilitate the follow-up. Another technique is connect with LinkedIn. LinkedIn, of course, you have to have your LinkedIn actualized in perfect condition with your profile. And when you exchange the LinkedIn profile, it's easier because with technology now, there is a code in the LinkedIn profile, so each one can scan the code of the other person, and you already connected with them. So that is excellent because it facilitates that when you go back to your office or your house or whatever, you start making in your computer, went to your phone number, a list of those people you connected in this event. For example, you go to an event January 16th and met 10 people there, so you put a list name of the event, the way you can remember where you meet them and what they took. And in the note, you can write a sentence about what did you talk with them in that night in the event. So how do you network yourself? That's important. You need to try to figure out what kind of event do you like. And what I found out is when you go to an event, because we are social persons, we enjoy being surrounded with people. After we make a decision, we go there. While we are there, we start enjoying. So we need to get out of our comfort zone. Don't be scared. Don't face the risk to make mistakes. It's the only way we can learn. It's the only way we can learn how to do better, making mistakes. Otherwise, we don't learn. And we are in an event, so there is one important subject that is anchor tenants. Who is the anchor tenant? The anchor tenant is a person that already you are see at the at him and is like a leader in this surrounding people, like a small group formed in the event. So you go to meet that person, he can introduce to the other person. And you can understand what the other person are interesting to. So you don't waste time. You gain time. That is the anchor tenant, the person who already is the leader of a small group inside, within the event, inside the event. Who is the super connector? The super connector is who organized the event, for example. Super connector, you connect with the super connector, with the person who is the organizer. You can ask the person, that person that introduced you with other people. So it's easier in that way. So if that is why required to be a strategy. That is why required to make a plan. Also in that plan, before going to the event, it's important, usually, if you go to an event that registers yourself, you can know how the people are knowing, are going in advance. So you can search those people online. Get to know them beforehand. So you know who are going to be there. So when you go, you are looking for them and you know more like the scene of them. It's like being a CI agent. It's knowing more about people. And why? Not only because you want to gain things or gain a job or a connection, it's because we are social persons and we build relationships. And those relationships in the long term are going to benefit us. I'm going to give you, a personal example. Like 15 years ago in Argentina, I was a mentor of an American student. And that in that way, I got along with his parents that live in New York. So his parents went to Argentina to visit him, and we became friends. Year passed, so in 2012, I had a project, work project, and because I stayed connected with those people, I came to New York. And I saved money in terms of, because they invite me to be in their house. And so I start working and having like being in my house with people I care. So look, something that I did 15 years ago, as a result, I didn't see 15 years ago that I was going to come to New York for a project in 2012. So I came, and so I have a house and people that I knew before. I lived like were in my house, like my home. What happened after that, by chance, they say, because I didn't speak English, I started studying English and meeting people, putting in practice all these things I'm telling you. And while doing this, I met a woman, and after 5 months, we got married. I never saw that it could happen. So networking is only gain business, it's to bring things to your life. In my case, it changed my life because I got married in the state. I need to stay here, so it changed everything. I moved here, and all this, the long history that is behind that. So what goes around, come around. So don't think in the short term. Think in the long term. But work for that. Make plans for the short term, middle term, and long term. Think when you go to meet a person, think what motivates that person. What is important for them? What energizes them? If you say, well, I don't have anything in common with that person. No, usually you will have something. For example, you like the same beer. or maybe you like the same sport, or you are close for blogs for your job and her job. So that's think about the other. Say about the other. But I told you about the mentor example. So then we need to follow up with the people. Follow up after the meeting and start building the relationship. There is a book, an old book, that is How to Make Friends, that it can be can help you to start networking more. And then it's important how to you are gonna dress for the event. Try to level up, usually not be too formal, but also not too informal. Usually a little bit more than is expected. That way we start meeting people, we start building our connection, we start building our reputation. And that reputation depends on the quality of people we are meeting. So let's see, next slide. So some qualities that come up doing networking. We start building our muscle. It's like going to the gym or doing exercise. Some people, like me, I struggle doing exercise. But after I put the goal, I go. After that, I start doing and I start enjoying. So it requires time, but you're going to start enjoying. Develop a thick skin, because then when you start follow up people, some people are going to tell you, no, I don't want to go to drink coffee with you. I don't want to grab a drink. I don't want to talk with you. Not all the people are going to get along with you. So if I want to have 5 new members of my network close to me, I maybe need to meet 100 people in a year to find new people in my network. So I need to develop a thick skin, because we need to be freely and easygoing with when we listen the no answer. No, I don't want to buy this thing. I don't want. Can you introduce me with that person? No. Okay, don't worry. Nothing happened. Be nice. Be giving. Be well. When I said building rapport, is keep having a history note about all the networking you are doing. The way that is systematic. It's a work. It's not a game. And as a result, you're going to have great connection, great friends, and great opportunity to solve problems. For example, there are moments that you don't know how to solve an operative problem. And you can, if you have met someone who is a contractor, you can call them. You already knew, but if you had met him, you could have called him. So it expand your network, expand your opportunity to solve problems. It's like Google. When we don't know something, we ask Google. Google is a second God. No? We ask a question, and Google gives us the answer. That's the way we need to understand our network. We need to see them as our team work. 10 years ago, no, in 2001, in Argentina, we have a big economic crisis. And I have a friend who had two important business, who lost everything. Everything, all the money in that moment. And he needed to start again. Many people in my country needed to start again. My country usually even 7 or 10 years happened this situation. So, but because he was a very hardworking person, ethic, so he reached out some of his friends and started a new business after 2 years, he started from the scratch. And it's not the same doing that in America than doing that in Argentina. In Argentina, it's more difficult because the situation is not favorable for that. So, but he did, thanks to his network. And I remember he told me that he learned something that I tried also to apply to me. He learned something after that crisis. He said, I pick some of my friends who are the best in their field, and I organize my own committee advisors. The way every time I need to make a decision or something is going to happen, I go to them individually and tell them my situation, and so I gain feedback. It's always smart. It's only smart because it doesn't cost any money. And you have advice from smart people and wise people. So coming to the end, let's see. Time management. We need to maximize our time. So we need to think. For example, is we have a time, we can schedule email to send during the week. We can schedule time during the weekend to send email, to write email that are gonna be sent during the week. Or the same, we can write a post for LinkedIn or Facebook that we are gonna post a few days after. That may us organize our time. It depends on everyone, but make a strategy plan, make a calendar. Ask yourself, when was the last time I met my chef, my friend chef from college, who is very knowledgeable with technology that I need now to implement in my project. He can help me, but when was the last time I met him? It was maybe 2 years ago. So we need to keep a regular interaction with them. So as a benefit, we're gonna get fresh ideas, advance our career, gets access to job opportunities, interconnect business contacts. We can connect one person with another, get career advice, support, build confidence, we feel that we are doing something toward our goal, get a different perspective, develop last relationship, gain answer to every question that we have, that we... The knowledge can have two possibilities. One, I have the answer, and the second, I don't have the answer. I don't have the answer or the knowledge, I need to look for it. So I can find the answer through my network. Well, that's coming to the end. So thank you, everyone, for having me here, and I open for questions.
Awesome, thank you so much, Coach Leo. We have a few questions here, but several of them asking similar things, so I condense them into two. The first question here is, what is a good way to engage someone in conversation when networking in a hectic environment?
In what kind of environment?
in a hectic environment?
Hectic environment. It means what topic is related, what topic to engage?
It says, what it's a good way to engage someone in conversation when networking in a hectic environment.
Okay, it can be the last trend. So you are in, I suppose you are in the tech environment is because you are in that field. So you have to know what is the last trend in that field and talk about that. But tell the person, hey, what do you think about the last development that had done Tesla or had done Microsoft?
Coach Lee, I think you might have misheard me. So they're talking about a hectic or busy or loud environment, networking in a loud environment.
Loud environment. That you cannot, with a lot of noise?
Mm-hmm.
That is tricky. It's a great question. Especially it's happened to me that I need to be very attent to understand in English what people say. And that the kind of environment is difficult. But be easygoing and ask the person to repeat and be close to the person. But usually there are space when you can get around, tell the person, let's go to talk at that corner, for example. But it depends. Some places, usually that is not a proper event for networking. Maybe it's a social event where you are networking. So, make sense?
I think so. I think you gave a good answer there. There's one other question that I put together from several different ones, which is, how soon after a networking event should someone reach out to the person they met?
After 48 hours. Before 48 hours.
Before 48 hours.
Send an email, send a text, connect, or say, it was a pleasure to meet you. And be natural. No, don't do a copy paste online looking for samples, emails, email samples. So be yourself and tell the person something or ask the person something, but connect before 48 hours.
Awesome. So that is it for us today. Thank you so much, Coach Leo.
Thank you very much. Thank you to you all.
So thank you everyone for joining us for Coach Leo's webinar today. I will be sending up a follow-up email with Coach Leo's contact information and recorded webinar. Thank you for joining us for all of our webinars last year. We are happy to kick this one off and bring so many more learning opportunities this month. I hope you all